In Washington State, Alan Northrup is getting ready to fight for 17 years of his life.
No, I've been up since 7 o'clock this morning.
17 years he spent in prison for a crime he didn't commit. This morning, Alan's on his way to the state capitol in Olympia to try to get something, anything, to compensate him for those years.
Well, I'm going to basically plead my case and let them know kind of what I went through, and hopefully they'll realize and understand, you know, that they need to hopefully make things right.
He'll ask lawmakers to pass a bill that would give him and others like him money and counseling for the time they spent behind bars. He did the same thing last year and got nowhere.
And what you go through in there mentally is just traumatic. It's something that's not even fathomable. It's not right.
Alan's nightmare began here, in Woodland, a small logging town on the Oregon-Washington border.
So in 1993, Alan's walking into his favorite bar, the Merwin Tap, and he thinks it's just a normal night. And as he walks in the door, he looks at the wall right here, and there's a wanted poster with a composite sketch that some of the patrons said looked just like Alan.
A few weeks after this picture was posted, Alan was at the bar next door.
I went to go make a pool shot on the side of the pool table, and as soon as I put my hand back, a cuff went on my wrist. And, of course, I instantly said, no, you got the wrong guy.
They did have the wrong guy, but nobody, other than Alan, would believe it for 17 years. He was charged with kidnapping and raping a housekeeper inside this home. With no physical evidence linking him to the crime, prosecutors relied on the eyewitness testimony of the victim, even though she had been blindfolded during most of the attack.
Well, I was saying, they'll figure it out that it's not me.
What did you think when they pronounced you guilty?
Well, I was devastated. I couldn't believe it. You know, and me? So you think I'd do that? Really?
Alan was sentenced to 23 years in prison. He left behind three children under the age of six.
The worst is not being able to watch my kids grow up.
If there's one thing you could get back from that time, what would it be?
Be able to share, you know, with them, you know, about their interests, good and the bad, you know, and the normal life of raising kids.
In 2000, the Innocence Project took his case. But for almost 6 years, prosecutors refused requests for new DNA testing. Finally, in 2009, after a judge's order and development of new testing methods, Alan got his results. Undeniable proof that his DNA wasn't on the victim.
Oh, man. I was jumping around the day room saying, I'm out of here.
Alan was released in 2010 after serving 17 years.
Was it hard to transition to the outside?
Yeah, absolutely. I had a really hard time with that. And I still do.
What did they give you when you got out?
Nothing.
He walked out of prison with just the money he had been sent by family and the earnings from his 42-cent-an-hour prison job. A little over $2,000. But he also got something else.
Yeah, I got hit with a child support bill of $111,000.
How were you expected to pay that?
Good question. I just looked at it and went, really?
There she is!
Innocence Project lawyer Laura Zarosky worked to free Alan.
My name is Laura Zarosky, and I'm the policy staff attorney with the Innocence
Now Project. She's working on legislation to give him and other exonerated prisoners compensation for their time wrongfully imprisoned.
There's sort of a gut reaction that this was a horrible injustice. Under the bill, they would be getting $50,000 for each year of wrongful conviction.
For Alan, that could mean as much as $850,000, money he could really use. He works at a factory and lives here with friends because he can't afford his own apartment.
If you got that money, what would that mean to you?
Oh, some breathing space. Be able to, you know, help out the family and just get started over again, you know. Start over a normal life again.
But the bill provides more than money. Counseling, job assistance, other social services. things that the guilty get automatically.
Under the Department of Corrections and Department of Social and Health Services, there are benefits and programs that are available for people who were guilty. And they just say flat out, they're not eligible because they weren't actually guilty. So they don't qualify, they don't fit our criteria.
Well,
is it possible to put a price on the number of years that you spent inside?
No, and there's no price on that at all.
Coming up, will legislators pass a law to compensate Alan Northrup? And even where there is compensation, sometimes it's an empty promise.
Imagine that Danny Brown is innocent. What should he do to clear his name?
Well, I don't know if he ever can.